Since yesterday, we have confirmed 22 new cases of COVID-19. This means that 119 cases have now been identified in our province. We suspect that 6 of these cases are community transmission. Our website does say 7. However, additional investigation has uncovered links for the one case. So again, it's now 6 cases of community transmission. Of the 119 cases, 6 individuals are receiving treatment in hospital, with 3 now in intensive care units. One previously diagnosed case was admitted to the ICU yesterday. All others are recovering in isolation at home with support from public health officials. As committed, aggregate data showing cases by age range and zone, as well as by local geographic areas, is now available online at alberta.ca/COVID-19. As of this morning, the online self-assessment tool that Alberta Health Services has provided has been accessed more than 1.3 million times. And to date, we have performed close to 15,000 tests. Per capita, we are testing more than any jurisdiction in North America. And just to put that in perspective, that means we have done one test for approximately every 290 Albertans. Our lab is doing amazing things, as are our healthcare providers who are doing contact tracing, those who are operating HealthLink phone lines, and those who are running the assessment centers. With respect to community transmission, yesterday I mentioned that we did have some concerns that I was going to speak more about today. Current information indicates that 2 of these cases are in Calgary and 3 in Edmonton who do not have obvious sources of their illness. In addition, 1 case in North Zone seems to have acquired infection while in Edmonton. This is concerning, and we are working to make sure that our testing and our testing availability is adjusted to make sure that we are understanding where cases of transmission are happening. As I mentioned before, we have been doing community tests for just over 10 days now, and we will continue to optimize the balance between testing people who've traveled and testing those who are sick but have not. One particular exposure I want to highlight today is that multiple cases of COVID-19 have been reported from attendees at the Pacific Dental Conference held in Vancouver from March 5th to 7th. As has been reported, we know that cases have been identified from that conference in other provinces across the country, and we have had over 7 cases to date, and more continue to be identified. Therefore, I am asking that all individuals who attended the Pacific Dental Conference self-isolate immediately, even if feeling well, and stay isolated until 14 days have passed from the conclusion of that conference. That would be March 22nd. Individuals who attended the conference and currently have symptoms should continue to stay home and complete the self-assessment tool online at ahs.ca/COVID to arrange for testing and further instructions. Do not go to the hospital or your family doctor for assessment. As a result of these confirmed cases, the Alberta Dental Association and College announced yesterday a mandatory suspension of all non-emergency dental treatment and services. Emergency dental treatment will continue. Yesterday, we also announced that all non-urgent scheduled and elective surgeries in Alberta are being postponed. Alberta Health Services is continuing to contact Albertans scheduled for procedures and will reschedule as soon as possible. Urgent and emergency surgery, as well as oncology and scheduled cesarean procedures, will continue. The decision to postpone elective surgeries and procedures was made by AHS staff to ensure that AHS has the equipment, the staff, and the beds available for the expected increased demand on our healthcare system caused by COVID-19. This is not just about increasing bed capacity. We need adequate numbers of frontline healthcare workers, as well as personal protective equipment, to handle the anticipated demand. This is a precautionary measure to ensure that we have the resources necessary to respond quickly as the rate of hospitalization is anticipated to increase. Later this afternoon, Alberta Health Services is moving to further restrict visitors to hospitals and care centres to protect patients and the most vulnerable. All visitors will need to be completely symptom-free, and only one visitor will be allowed at a time. Children will be restricted from visiting. Children do not necessarily show symptoms of COVID-19 or have very mild symptoms. Exceptions for children will be reviewed and approved by unit managers or nursing staff on a case-by-case basis for exceptional circumstances only. If you have an illness that can be transmitted with symptoms including fever, cough, loose stools, a rash, or generally feeling unwell, you cannot visit a loved one in the hospital. You will not be allowed in. If you are on self-isolation for COVID-19, or if you are being tested for COVID-19, you cannot visit a loved one in hospital. If you have tested positive for COVID-19, you cannot visit and will not be allowed to visit until you have recovered and received clearance from medical officials. If you are unable to visit, please use other methods to be in touch with your loved one, such as a phone call, video calling, or FaceTime. We recognize that this will likely be difficult for families and loved ones, but we must do all we can to minimize the risk of infection to our residents and staff. As you heard earlier from the Premier, the effects of COVID-19 are widespread and unprecedented. COVID-19 has forced us to make some extremely difficult decisions. We have had to weigh lives against livelihoods. And in order to save lives, I have had to make recommendations that will take away livelihoods for many Albertans over the next several weeks to months. I know that many Albertans are suffering as a result of these measures, and I ask that we all reach out to our neighbours and networks over the next while with compassion and support. We need to support not just those who may be infected with COVID-19 or self-isolating, but also those who have been impacted in other ways, through lost jobs or less income, as a result of the measures we have needed to put in place to slow down the spread of this virus. There are no easy solutions to the situation we are in, not just in Alberta, but around the world. We need to face this together and respond to this extraordinary crisis with extraordinary kindness. While the measures we have taken are necessary and required to contain COVID-19, it does not make them any easier. I take these decisions very seriously, and the repercussions will be felt in all aspects of our lives and society. The days and months ahead will be difficult for all of us. We are all needed in this response, and the actions each of us take are important to pulling through together.